The second floor of a light manufacturing building is constructed from a 120 mm thick stone concrete slab with an added 50 mm thick cinder concrete fill as shown. If the suspended ceiling of the first floor consists of metal lath and gypsum plaster, determine the dead load for design in kilonewton per square meter of floor area. Repeat again. We need to determine the dead load for design in kilonewton per square meter of floor area. First of all, we need to look at the picture at the left. We see the stone concrete slab is 120 millimeters thickness, cinder concrete fill on the slab is 50 millimeters thickness, and below the slab is ceiling of metal lath and gypsum plaster. So, we can determine the problems easily. Look at the table 1.3 about minimum design dead loads. We see the floor fill stone concrete is 0.023 kilonewton per square meters multiply millimeters. After that, we see the cider concrete is 0.017 kilonewton per square meters multiply millimeters. The ceiling suspended metal lath and gypsum plaster is 0.48 kilonewton per square meters. Hence, we multiply the minimum design dead loads of floor fill stone concrete with thickness of our slab. The answer of the weight of stone concrete slab is 2.76 kilonewton per square meter. The answer of the weight of cider concrete fill on slab is 0.85 kilonewton per square meter. And also the answer of the ceiling suspended metal lath and gypsum plaster is 0.48 kilonewton per square meters. After we know the dead loads of each materials, we can find the total dead loads of our slab. Therefore, the answer is 4.09 kilonewton per square meters. Here is the way that we computed the dead load for design in kilonewton per square meter of floor area. Do you think this video helped you or not? If it is helpful, like, comment and share this video to your classmates. Thanks.